All right. This is Sumant Castro, CEO and founder of Specify Technologies Private Limited. We believe making small steps progressively towards precision will eventually make us reach the elusive perfection. Our big, hairy, audacious goal, or our massive transformative purpose, is to save billions annually by reducing rework and waste. And we are going to do that by doing things right the first time. Currently, we are targeting the construction industry, which has got an annual global turnover of $10 trillion, out of which 16%, as per McKinsey, is going into inefficiencies and waste. That's the piece that we are going after. How are we doing that? First, we have digitized the quality control processes by making it digital, authentic, real-time workflows, customized checklist and approval system. That is the product that we have already built called DigiQC. But as we move forward, we're going to build in machine learning and artificial intelligence to make it even more precise. Why are we going after that? Quality control, the way it is right now, is a big mess. Time is wasted in duplication, standardization makes it inflexible, documents are doctored, lost, damaged, traceability and accountability is a big hassle, a big time lag between failure and remedy. And obviously there is lack of visibility from top management. There is a data retrieval is almost impossible. And there is no way to evaluate the failure trends and improve from that. What are we doing about it? DigiQC is the way of digitizing and solving all of these problems. It's real time, on the job site, only by authorized persons, a very flexible framework that can fit any organization type. There is option of photo and voice recording to save, you know, typing time. It's stage-wise and connected, so various supply chains can converge and all the documentation gets connected. It's obviously searchable and very speedy retrieval because of the cloud computing. Instant notification make remedy and resolutions very fast. And of course, we learn from the previous mistakes through analytics and intelligence built into it. It's tamper-proof and uncircumventable, so fraud is avoided. And we have also built in remote approvals. That's our product, DigiQC. Why is it coming now? First of all, everyone has now started using smartphones on all job sites. We have got high data speeds, low cloud costs. Even though the complexity, the magnitude of the jobs are increasing, the senior team is limited. And by DigiQC, we leverage the Gen Z in the workforce to become their eyes and use the wisdom which is centrally located across the job sites. We do that because DigiQC in the cloud connects the entire organization, right from the executives and the managers who are mostly involved in the quality assurance and decision-making, down to the site engineers who are on the job site, and sometimes the experts who are giving remote approvals. The remote approval is a very improved process where the inspector is on the job site and the expert can be anywhere in the world and can still provide their wisdom. Very soon, we will be coming up with our machine learning assisted artificial intelligence module in which the job site engineer will get predictions from our smartphone interface on the level of confidence about whether the inspection that they're doing is worth passing or they should fail it. And we will obviously be building on top of that. We have been in several competitions, sometimes winning them, sometimes being the runner-up. And we launched our product during COVID, and still we are getting some traction from very reputed companies like HCP, Sangini, etc. With just a second month of traction for us. Myself, I have an MBA in finance from the States, and a construction technology degree from SET Ahmedabad. I have 22 years of experience in real estate as well as in construction in US as well as in India. And my co-founder and CTO, Nachiket, he's a master's in computer technology and has more than 12 years of building world-class computer applications and cloud-based computing. We have everything that good founders should have to make their startup big. We believe our B2B SaaS product, DigiQC, will make quality measurable and build reputations of the people who use it. And of course, we will save the billions that we are going after. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for great pitch. Any questions? Yes, please.
So, as I understand, you have just pilots for today, yes, correctly?
Can you repeat, please?
As I understood, today you have just pilots, yeah, not real clients yet.
No, the companies I mentioned are real clients. We have received commitment fees from them, and they are all evaluating their organizations on the deployment. So rather than the entire company being on DigiQC, they have identified two or three projects each where we are already deployed and in the process of deploying, which it's been like 6 weeks since we started this. 6 weeks since we started deploying. And we believe all of them would want to use it across their organizations.
So what would be a typical customer persona?
This will be a construction company, either a general contractor or a consulting company responsible for the entire job site. So in India, generally the owner has a team who controls construction and hires various contractors and subcontractors. But in US, the general contractor becomes the main person who would use it. So it depends on the nature of the contracts that they are.
So sure. What's the average transaction value you have assumed around these contracts?
So yeah, I mean, we have two models. First one is the retail model, for which a user license would be given on an annual basis for $135, which is 10,000 rupees Indian. And an organization, if they go for an unlimited everything, would get the same thing for $9,900 per year, in which there would be no limits on the type of projects and the number of users. And again, we are not where we feel, I mean, we don't have product market fit yet. We are right now, we believe we have product solution fit. So we are also experimenting with different pricing models. But these numbers that I mentioned are based on our study of the very simplistic value proposition of the time that we are saving. The saving of the rework is, of course, a much higher value proposition.
Okay.
Have you done some pilots where the clients see the value?
Yes, for 6 months we have been doing pilots. In fact, the company that is going to build the Parliament House of India has been our pilot. A beta pilot client, and they have used it on three major projects, mostly mass housing and one aquarium. And in fact, a lot of the product features that we incorporated later on was based on their feedback. And there were one infrastructure company and one project management company. These three were the primary beta testers for us. And great. Alpha testing we did in projects which were closer to where we are based in Surat.
Sure. Thank you.
We are on iOS as well as Android.
Thank you so much. Any questions else?
Thank you.
Let's continue. Yes, Kate, let's continue.